Rest in peace.
Lamar Davis, what's up?
I'm part of the team. That's what's up.
Team? I don't do teams.
Devin Weston's car stealing team? The one Frank's running.
Oh, yeah, that one.
Hey, look, I boosted the ride. I'm about to meet your boy Franklin, and I need your ass to pick up the Packer, meet us outside the garage, and we taking these motherfuckers up to Palito Bay.
All right, buddy. Fine. That's a long trip.
You just turned this into a book!
The boost, homie. How'd it go? Any problems?
You know me, fool.
Yeah, I do know you, fool.
So what you think? Smooth as silk.
I'm thinking where the blood stains and the bullet holes and shit.
Man, fuck. That amateur shit behind me, I'm a professional now, like you and them old dudes.
So tell me what happened.
I saw the ride. I took the ride. No drama.
No security. No one saying, who the fuck is this gangly motherfucker doing in my car?
Nothing.
That's worrying, man. That's some shady ass shit.
Man, chill.
In the truck, let's go.
Sonora Freeway, pass from Palito Bay. Hey, it's cozy in here.
Scooch up, homie.
Yeah, scooch over here.
Scooching in that crazy dude? Oh, hell no, that nigga stank.
Get over here. I don't bite.
That ain't what I heard. All cannibalistic and shit.
Frank, what you been telling him?
I say what I see, homie. You dig on man meat.
Rumor and hearsay. We got a long way to go. I get comfortable.
All right, nigga, but don't try nothing.
How far is it?
And this thing? About 4 hours.
Shit.
It's your operation, Slick.
Shit, if you all right driving, I'm gonna catch up on some sleep.
Go for it.
It's all right being the boss. Meant to be running things, but this fool was asleep.
Yeah, I'll be asleep when your ass stop talking, nigga.
Some boss. Hey, man, what that other dude? The dude that creeped on that dude.
Michael, his creeping days are done.
Well, what you mean? He stopped creeping?
No more creeping for him.
He, like, retired from creeping?
From everything.
That's funny, because, like, the boy Frank didn't mention shit about that. And as a matter of fact, I don't even know the dude. But considering the mutual acquaintances we got, I would have liked an invite to the retirement party.
There weren't no party.
No party?
I used the term retirement euphemistically.
Homie, for a dude that kills dudes and eats dudes and fuck dudes, you talk fruit.
It's unconfirmed.
What's unconfirmed? The fact that you talk stupid or the fact that you do some messed up shit? Or where the other dudes at? Like, maybe he's dead.
The last one.
Oh, shit, man. Fuck! Do Frank know about this?
I don't know if Franklin knows, but let's just let him sleep.
Shit.
Yeah, it's a bummer. But, you know, he wasn't the good guy he made out.
That dude was a killer, a thief, a liar, and irritable as shit.
Yeah, a liar.
Homie, you sound like some bitch didn't call. Like, goodbye to me.
I am some bitch he didn't call for 10 years.
Fuck, man. Fuck, too.
Hobo. Maybe tired of hobo. Freedom. Boners in the night.
cut up women and get other dudes to jack them off. Come to think about it, aside from not lugging freight around the country, you gotta buy all the necessary prerequisites for a fine career in Hollywood.
No shame in that.
If you don't want to get paid or enjoy human contact.
Money's bullshit. So is friendship.
All right, all right, all right. I see you still touching.
How's Franklin doing over there?
Aw, dude getting paid to sleep. Don't even worry about it.
Sleep of innocence.
So he, like, in charge on this one? You work for him?
He's a kind of figurehead. Puppet, if you like.
With Devin West's hand up his ass.
Right up to the elbow.
That dude feels safe.
Ooh, it's repulsive. But, well, once he's paid us, he can be whatever we want him.
What you want?
I want him to be someone who understands that all the money in the world can't save him from a nasty guy who thinks he's an asshole.
That's something I want to see. So, tell me, man, how y'all end up meeting?
Michael introduced us. Me and Frank didn't exactly travel in similar circles.
Nah, I mean the creeper.
Michael? Ha, I don't know.
Yeah, you know.
Sorry, I don't want to reminisce. The wounds ain't healed.
You such a delicate little bitch, ain't you? Where your pussy at? What you got in there?
Screw you!
That's good. Let it out, homie. Go on, let it out. Vent.
The turd was probably playing me from the start.
Right, yeah. Probably. How you doing? Where? When?
Alright. Alright! Fuck! I was running this small air freight outfit in North Yankton. Tiny operation. This one beagle I could borrow when I needed it. We were kids.
Kids with planes.
So, this guy I know says there's this other guy needs some hot cargo moving across the border. Money's good. And I don't know enough to check references, so I'm in. A few days later, I'm waiting on the runway. I see this dust coming up off the road. Only it ain't one dust trail, it's two. I got told one guy in cargo. First car comes through the gate, stops, someone comes out. My age, just 20, kind of fat but stronger.
Love at first sight.
Yeah, something like that. Other car comes through the gate. Old guy falls out, starts yelling, waving his arms and pointing at the kid.
The dude that got... Jack?
Who fucking knows? Fat guy's running, old guy's shouting. I don't really care. I play peacemaker, concerned citizen. I get close to the old guy and I pull out this flare gun I'm carrying around, squeeze the thing off in his eye.
Shit.
That was horrible. We had to pick up the body and dump it in a lake on the way. The thing was still burning in his head when we dropped him. The plane never smelled the same. Both of us threw up when we landed. It was quite a baptism.
You ain't never clapped nobody before?
Not really. Some deer, foxes, drifters, nothing serious.
Ha! So that was like it? You and Michael rolling on through?
Mas o menos. Michael didn't have the nerve back then. I didn't have the direction. Kinda worked.
Until Michael got his nerve.
Oh, this shit, what's that?
Wake up, you dozy motherfucker. What time was on the ride?
What you gonna do, old fearless leader?
Okay, shit, I got an idea. Keep driving. I'm gonna take the tricked out JB-700 and get rid of the tail. Man, Molly said there'd be some hardware on board. Shit, we'll see.
Hey, take this headset.
We have a visual. brought the cops right to us, dawg.
Maybe you should have done a boost, Mr. CEO. Now get on the shit.
Suspect going down.
CEO, deal with the one time.
Later, Bay.
Right to us, dog.
Maybe you should have been the first to see him. Now get on the shit. These cops gave us a run. You're showing him wrong, Frank.
Suspect eastbound, north of... Clinton, where are you?
We're coming up to GO8. Man, the cops was all over us. They slowed us down some.
That's not surprising. The insurance companies have been pressurizing them to find you since the studio break-in.
You knew there'd be heat? Man, you could have told us.
Don't get emotional. We're waiting at Procopio Truck Stop. Be here soon.
I'm taking a ride to the truck stop at Procopio. I'm gonna speak to the legal counsel one. Get us paid.
Yeah, I heard about this CEO pay shit. Just make sure it's fair salary for the workforce, motherfucker. Yeah, what he said.
You taking care. Head back to town. meditating or ripping somebody off?
In light of the drama your efforts caused, it's not perhaps the best idea for you two to be seen together for a while.
Where's the money?
Mr. Weston is one of the most brilliant investors the world has ever known. He's obviously a maverick, but he's also rigorous in his research.
Yeah, he may be brilliant. Look, let me be the first to tell you. He ain't gonna fall in love with your ass. Now where the fuck is my money?
The best thing that could have happened to you in the situation has happened. He is going to hold your money, invest it in his Alpha Fund, and make the funds available to you at a time as the transfer will not induce any undue attention.
Which is a polite way of saying I'm getting robbed? Are you fucking kidding me?
That is a short-sighted and frankly immature way of seeing things, Mr. Clinton. Let's go.